is far greedier than...
Well, you were telling me about your appointment with the doctor.
Yeah, everything's okay.
Oh, good. Because you got mad at Adam because he left, huh?
Yeah. I guess I'm just being silly.
No, no, I don't think so.
I guess, I don't know, honestly, Stuart, I guess I was just more hurt than mad. He seemed like he really wanted to hear the baby's heartbeat, and then when we got there, his mind was just a million miles away.
Oh, Dixie, that's just the way he is. He really doesn't want to hurt people. But he just doesn't think things through sometimes.
Well, how'd everything go with the doctor?
Everything's fine.
Good. What are you doing?
Oh, I'm helping Dixie.
I'm knitting a sweater for the baby. Would you like to see? Look.
Oh, yeah, very nice.
Adam, sweetheart, why don't we go out to dinner tonight? You know, someplace romantic?
Oh, no, Pam.
Why not? We have to eat.
No, I don't have time. Better grab a bite to eat, get right back to the office. I've got a pile of paperwork waiting for me there.
Well, that's just fine. That's fine. I have to, help Lainey get ready for the prom anyway. Thanks, Stuart.
Yeah.
Take care.
Okay.
Goodbye.
You could have apologized.
For what?
For upsetting her. You hurt her feelings.
She'll get over it.
She's your wife, Adam. How can you treat her like that?
Like what?
Like she's not good enough to talk to.
You don't love her. You couldn't love her and be so cold. You know, I really don't need this right now.
Everybody was right. You just married her because of the baby.
Oh, well, not that again.
You're still in love with Brooke.
Look, I don't want to talk about this right now, all right?
And that's why you're so unhappy. All right, damn it, I married her because I wanted my child. My child, Stuart. You never loved her?
No. You satisfied? Oh, come on, Stuart. People are getting married all the time who aren't in love with each other. The important thing is that I love the child she's carrying, and that child will be born legitimately. Hell, it's a damn noble thing I'm doing here.
Poor Dixie.
Poor Dixie. She's living the life she dreamed of. She loves you. She's just a kid. Take my word for it, the time will come when she'll wake up from this dream world of hers and realize we're totally wrong for each other.
Do you really think it's going to happen?
Yes, I do.
Ross thinks that you're going to divorce her as soon as the baby comes. Is that true?
Why don't you answer me? You don't expect me to spend the rest of my life with her, do you?
Return the suit at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. Just kidding. You look marvelous. You look great, seriously. Nobody would ever guess that you just ate half a dozen Italian sausages.
Until you breathe on them.
Breath mints. Where are they?
I don't know. If I were you, I'd drink some kerosene and swallow a match. That might work.
Get the idiot.
Better.
Okay.
Try these. They're the original mouth whack.
All right.
And, listen. Don't do anything I wouldn't do, okay?
Hey, if I can do half of the stuff that you do, I'd have a great time, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Later. Bye.
Joseph?
What?
Aren't you forgetting something?
What?
Your fam's corsage.
Oh, jeez.
Thanks.
Take it easy.
Okay. All right, okay.
Would you relax?
I'll see you later, all right? Oh, does that look okay?
Don Johnson should look so good.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Dose it. I won't wait up.
So it's Ted Martin.
Oh, thanks. Mm-hmm. Hello, Ted.
Where the hell have you been? I've been calling all over for you.
What's this about?
I'll explain later. Where can we meet?
I'm going home. I mean, if you want, you can meet me at home.
What about Adam?
Well, he's working late again.
Great. I'll see you in 5 minutes, okay?
Okay, great.
Aren't you?
Yeah, Ted's my best friend. Not that says very much, because I don't have that many friends to speak of.
Well, you can certainly count me in there.
Well, that's sweet. Huh. You think maybe he's a star?
Not unless he's in New York. They're having a big temple party there. You know, you really are very lucky.
I am.
That Adam's gotten over this jealousy thing, and some men can drive you right up the wall.
Oh. Well, that took him a little while, you know. But you should have seen him today. Oh, my goodness, he was offering him pay and everything, like Ted was with King of England.
Well, what do you think caused this big turnaround? If I'm getting too personal.
Wait a minute. I think I just figured out where he might be.
Kelly's, good evening.
Hi. Could I ask you a question? Is Ted Martin there, please?
Ted Martin? No, I'm sorry, he's not.
Are you sure?
Yeah, believe me, if Ted Martin were here, we'd all know. Is this Dixie? Is that you?
Yeah, this must be Cecily. How are you?
Fine, thanks.
Good. Hi. Do me a big favor, would you?
Sure.
If Ted comes into the club, would you have him call me right away?
Sure. Dixie, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What are you doing tonight?
Sitting around. Listen, about Ted. Cecily, I think it's very important. He might be missing.
Missing?
I mean, he was supposed to meet me ages ago. Now I feel like he's just disappeared off the face of the earth.
And you're going crazy. Listen, Dixie, I'm going crazy myself. I'll come over, all right? Bye-bye.
Could you look at him exercising his libido? He's being friendly. Good heavens, are you blind? And Bambi, I thought you had accepted Nico and Cecily's marriage. I mean, last week you were bubbling away about their nuptial bliss. So what is it? What is this new bee that's buzzing around in your bonnet?
All right, I'll confess, I have recently heard some very disturbing allegations.
What? That Nico chats to his singers?
Oh, that's shocking. That he's after her fortune. Sean Cudahy told me that he...
Sean Cudahy? Come on, really?
All right, I'll admit that Sean is not exactly...
Shabby. Fringe benefits. You shut up and move it. You relax. Somebody could walk in. Will you come on? Did you find any more goodies? Everything was already in the bag. That's gonna put one big grin on Adam Chandler's face.
To the Tad experience, aren't you? Mm. If that guy ever showed up on time, it'd be a national holiday.
Oh. Well, he did stand up Scotty the other night.
You see, you're worrying too much. Mm. When did he and Sky become an item?
Oh, well, I really think they're just friends.
But you're right. You know, I think you're absolutely right. I think I'm just worrying too much. Well, listen, it's no wonder. I mean, you're all alone in this house and... Where's Adam? Is he on a business trip or something?
No, he's just working late.
After 10?
Yeah, you know how it is.
Being married to a mogul, no, not really.
Mm.
But tell me, is it everything you expected?
No, it's a lot more.
Are you so in love that you can't stand it?
I'm so in love. I can seem to forgive just about anything. Like today, it's...
What happened?
Well, it was nothing. It was just a little tiff, is all.
Oh, listen, you don't have to tell me if you don't want to.
Oh, no. It was just, alone a lot of the time, you know, and then he's always working, and... Well, the time that we do spend together is mine. Well, what can I say, you know? I mean, it's just the best.
Is he always bringing you, like, flowers and little mementos, like jewelry?
Oh, yeah, he does that all the time.
Oh, I'm so jealous.
Well, doesn't Nico do that for you?
Oh, yes, he does. He brings me flowers, but, you know, Nico is more like a mogul in the making, and oh. I'm a mogulette, I guess. I don't know.
That was good.
The two of us are quite, we're like Romeo and Juliet.
I like that.
No, it's not a very good choice. I mean, they died at the end.
Yeah.
No, he and I are, we just keep getting closer and closer.
That's great. You're really lucky. I mean, because you get to work together, you know?
Oh, we work together. We play together. We're quite a team.
Well, we really didn't do too badly, did we?
No, we, listen, here is to, two happily married women.
What the hell are you doing here?
Mission accomplished.
I told you I'd pay you tomorrow at the train station.
Yeah, well, we didn't get to discuss our bonus.
What bonus?
I think you'll agree we deserve one when you see what we found in Martin's apartment.
If you're interested.
Don't play games with me. What do you have? See for yourself.
Medical records. There's more.
Hey, Chandler. Afternoon, June 20th. That little slime was bugging me.
I say, you got the goods on you.
Now, how about that bonus? Yeah, tomorrow. Union Station. I'll double the money. Now, go on.
Yes, sir.
I hope to hell Martin paid for this.
No, I think he did.
Knocking?
I did.
What are you doing here anyway?
Well, I thought I heard someone. You all right?
If I need your help, I'll ask for it.
Mr. Chandler, I'm at your service.
All right, fine. You want to help? Call a security firm. I want this entire complex swept for bugs. ASAP.
Yes, sir. May I ask why?
No. Just do it.
Yes, sir.
The wrong guy, Martin. Nobody, but nobody is going to come between me and my child.
I can't believe this is still at home.
Look, Dixie.
No, it is after midnight. He would have called me by now.
thing was, he said that he was coming right over.
A million things could have happened.
Right. All of them bad. I just have this feeling in my bones, Cecily. I know something is wrong. Maybe I should just give it up and call
police. No, I would not do that. No.
He could be lying in a gutter in a pool of blood somewhere.
Or he could be holed up in some sleazy motel room with some sleaze.
Oh.
Look, he would be furious if you stick the police on him.
You're right.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we'll just have to do it ourselves.
What?
Well, you got your car, don't you?
Yes, but I
had nothing. Let's go.
You should be upstairs in bed. You are in no condition to be running around town.
No. Hopefully, I am fine. Now, are you going to let me go by myself or what?
No, of course not.
What is all this excitement?
Nothing. Nothing. We're just simply going to look for Ted Martin. That's all.
Talking to statues now is much worse than I thought.
What do you want?
Seriously, if there's anything wrong...
Why does everyone think there's something wrong? There is nothing wrong.
All right. Would you like a brandy?
No, thank you.
So, did anything interesting happen today?
I would... not in the mood for an interview right now, thank you.
I'm just trying to make conversation.
I'm going up to my wife. Don't try so hard.
She's not here.
What?
I said she's not here.
Where is she?
She left a little while ago with Cecily Kelly.
She went to Kelly's?
No, she went to look for Ted.
His car is not here.
Well, it's probably in the garage.
Well, if he's here, why isn't he answering the phone?
Well, I don't know. That's why we're here to find out.
Wait. Lights are out. That means people are asleep.
Well, that's just too bad.
Phyllis, he could be in New York, he could be in Center City, he could be in Iowa. You should be home in bed.
I am fine.
You're risking your baby's health. You are not Tad's nanny.
Well, let's go before we regret this.
Let me just look. You're right. There's nobody there. You better just take me home.
Has been robbed and beaten. We found him at his house.
Dixie and Cecily brought Tad to the hospital, and they very probably saved his life.
Beaten?
Yeah, it was by two guys in ski masks.
In his own home?
Yeah. He's hurt really badly, and we're just all praying that he's going to be okay.
Oh. How much did they steal?
We have no idea.
Well, what is this world coming to? People beaten in their own homes by thugs? Well, you do have property insurance, I take it.
We're not concerned about the damned insurance, Adam. It's our son we're worried about.
Well, yes, of course. And not to mention the crime rate. This has happened in Center City, that's one thing. But right here in Pine Valley, it's a jungle out there. Yeah, I don't suppose Tad got a look at his assailants. Oh, no. You said they were ski masks, right? And gloves. No doubt, yes. And no fingerprints. No way to identify them.
No, I think they were probably professionals.
The good ones rarely get caught.
Well, don't you be so certain. This time we'll make sure they get caught and they pay for it.
I certainly hope so.
Well, I guarantee it. Believe me.
Two cracks.
No fracture of the cranium, huh?
A heavy concussion.
I'd like to keep him here a little longer for observation.
We're going to have a room opening up on 6 West.
Okay. How long exactly is he going to have to be in the hospital?
I would say a few days, a serious blow to the head.
And the broken ribs as well.
But they will mend, right?
Yes, if he's careful.
But we can insure you by keeping him here. I mean, my son doesn't call me eagle eyes for nothing, right?
Are you two all right?
Oh, yes, we just... So he leaves, is okay. Let's check the CBC breath.
No. I was sitting there in the car. I was so worried. I kept trying to wake him up, but he just wouldn't move.
Tell me something. Did Tad say anything about the men who assaulted him?
No, I'm sorry, he didn't say much.
No, he just said that there were two of them, and that they took his wallet, and that they were both wearing ski masks.
I'm sorry to say your house is a mess.
Yes, take him to the hospital, and he fainted. Adam, I... Where's Adam?
Dixie told me about your broken ribs and your concussion.
What are you doing here?
Just a bedside visit to a friend. Unfortunate accident, Tad. Wrong place at the wrong time.
No accident. It was you. You did it.